morning, dear children. Today is our English class. I hope and I believe that you all might have enjoyed your previous classes in English. And today is our new topic. We are going to see about a new topic, okay? So, okay, I want to ask you a question, children. Do you all like animals? Like maybe some of you may like and some of you may say that you don't like animals. You may say that you like birds or something else like that, isn't it? And one more question is, do you all have your favorite animals? Like, I like this animal, I like that animal. We all have favorites, isn't it? So now you can take that in your mind and tell me, or you don't need to tell me, you can think it in your mind that you'll be having a favorite animal, isn't it? And can you tell me, which is the largest land animal that you know? Like from childhood we have learned, king of the forest means we say it is lion. And then what is the largest animal in the water? We say it is whale. And now I'm asking you, which is the largest animal in the land animal? So we all know it is elephant, isn't it? So now I don't want to describe you about an elephant, but you all know that elephant is very huge and it has a big long trunk, and then ears are literally very big and the eyes are big or small. Yes, it is very small, okay, very tiny. It has a huge body, but its eyes is very tiny. And then you all know it is very huge, okay? So, here in this poem, this is not a lesson. We are going to see about a poem titled, Make Room for Elephant. Okay, Make Room for Elephant. The writer of this poem is Ruskin Bond. And he has written this, all about the poem. And here, he a small boy, describes about an elephant. And this boy is like some of us, he is very kind to the animals. He wants to be kind and he is very loving too. So now he is thinking of his in his mind about this world and about this elephant. Okay, so let's go into our poem. I'll read you the poem. You just hear the poem. Okay, I know the world's a crowded place. Okay, and elephants do take up space. But if it makes a difference, Lord, I'm glad we share my room and board. Here are the first, when we see the first four lines of this poem, I know this world is crowded place. It is a crowded place, okay? Plenty of people, millions of people, crores of people are there. And we know that we don't have space to live. Even the people, we don't know. Then how can we have, we may think that to have a space for an elephant to come and stay along with us. It's not possible, isn't it? But here, in this poem, a boy sees an elephant with a baby elephant. And now he knows that he cannot take this elephant to his house and make them stay there because it is very crowded. So here he is very sad to tell that his world is very crowded and there is no room for the elephant to stay. Okay, but then he says that he can make a difference. What difference is make now? He can give something. He can feed that elephant and whatever. He's willing to feed the elephant food and the meal. So that is what he wants to say. And then a baby elephant would too. So now the boy wants to take the baby elephant to his room. And he wants the elephant to stay with him. And now he took the elephant. But if he brings his mother too. Mother too means baby elephant has a mother. There is a dad's courage. He won't mind. He knows that the little baby, baby elephant can stay in his room. But the mother elephant can't stay in his room because his room is very small. And you know that elephant is very huge. Isn't it? So he thought that he can make the mother elephant stay in the garage. Garage means where we keep the car and all. That is called garage. Here the gladly means willingly. And then board means offering a food or meal to someone else. Okay. So now he was thinking, okay, I can make the big elephant to stay in daddy's garage. And now he was telling. So it is okay. Because his father is also okay with this idea. and now he was thinking of his mother. See, two elephants is more than kind, okay? But I wonder what my mom would say if the elephant's father come to stay. So now he is okay with the baby elephant. Baby elephant could stay with the boy, and the mother elephant will stay in the daddy's garage. And now he was thinking, if the father comes, if baby elephant's father comes, what will mother do? Now he was thinking, like, if mother won't agree to make the elephant to stay, it is a poor thing. So he was just worried of that in this manner a poem ends, okay? So now here the author tried to say, like, we all have to have a heart to be kind with the animals. We know that we can't make all the animals to stay with us, but whatever it is, many animals stay nearby, like cows, dogs, donkeys stay. Let's be kindful to them, and with a glad heart we can treat them in a good way. Okay, that is all the poem tells you in this Make Room for Elephant. Coming to the book exercise, children, page number 32, play with words here. Be, okay, suffix. You know what is suffix? I don't know whether you have learnt about it, but I would like to tell you what is suffix. Okay, it is a group of letters in means. See, can you see here? YALTION FULABLE and LY. These are the words, letters. It will be ending in a word. For example, here, wonder. So when you add FUL, it becomes wonderful. Okay, now, like here, PAINT, paint. When you add ER, it becomes painter. So like that, okay? When you add some letters to the group, here paint means it's like when we do coloring or whatever. When you add ER, it becomes painter. It describes about a person or tells about some person, okay, in groups. So that is how it is said that such letters groups are called suffixes, okay? So here we are going to add such words. I'll give you the answers. You just try, okay? I'll tell you. That was a wonderful meal. Shaheen's mother is a famous painter. Dinesh is very likely person, okay? You can use mashed potatoes to thicken the soup. Thicken na katti aakkaradhukku. Reena has bought a very colorful scarf. Okay, next is, we've spent a very enjoyable day at the beach. So complete this student. Okay, next, coming to pronouns. What are pronouns? Words such as I, we, us, you, he, him, she, her, they and them, that are used in the place of nouns. You know what is noun, isn't it? So in the place of noun, we are going to use these words like I, we, us, you, he, him, she, her, they. Okay, here. So here, replace the underlined words with the suitable pronouns. The nouns are given. We are going to replace them into pronouns by using these words like this. Okay, they, he, his, her. Elephants are very large animals. Elephants is a noun, is the name of a noun. So we are going to replace them into a pronoun. So we say they take up, instead of elephant, we say they. That is going to be the pronoun. Next, Meena and Rita are cousins. Okay. Next, Meena and Rita, again noun is there. Meena and Rita, it's the name of a person. Two persons are there. So instead of Meena and Rita, we use the word they as a pronoun there. Okay. Next, the princess is very kind. The princess is very, it is, princess means only a one, it says about only a single person. Okay, princess na Rani. So we say she is very honest. Okay, instead of the princess, we can replace it as she. So do this, children. Next, stick the correct pronouns given with the brackets. Leela is happy. What's the answer? Here the pronoun, she. Okay, he. Then Mughal and Madhu said that they are busy today. Today is my mother's birthday. So we are going to celebrate. So these, pick up the pronouns from here and write in the dash. Okay. And write a funny poem in this. Leave it. That's all for class, in the that you have to do in the exercise in the book, children.
remaining things, only few meanings and opposites I'll give you. And even these questions write in your classwork note, okay? Use ink pen. Again, I'm repeating you. Try to use ink pen while you write in your classwork note. Thank you.